Right, anyway, yeah. Game Paradise Streams, Longview 01. Mario's Time Machine with, as I said before, my little cheat sheet. Little cheat sheet. So I can cheat at Mario's Time Machine. But I haven't cheated because technically I sat down and worked this fucker out earlier, so. Yeah, just throw the cart in the bin. It's a shitty game. Alright. So here we go, Mario's Time Machine. So basically, Bowser has stolen. He's stolen a load of shit, and you've got to collect it. So here we go. We've got a torch. And I know from looking at my little cheat sheet, we have to go to 776 BC. Like that. All that Googling. There you go. And then you have to take the torch and put it in the right place, and you get little clues. Which I'm not going to be able to reach the fucker, so we won't be able to look at that clue, but basically it's a torch, and it's an Olympic torch, and you have to go over here, hit that, see, look, these athletic contests are held as a religious festival in honor of Zeus, the ruler of the gods, and that's Zeus, the ruler of the gods, not Zeus from the film Die Hard of a Vengeance. Right, and then we get the torch, we place it there, and you get a little thing saying, thank you, now the torch has been lit, let the games begin. Put it back there, we go back in to the same level. Oh, and we missed the fucking thing. Okay. This is so monotonous. There we go. A light bulb. There you go. So I know with a light bulb, we have to go to 1879, which must have been when the light bulb was invented. 1879. I hope you're all learning something tonight. Yeah. There we go. I have to find the bookcase with the gramophone. We'll have a little fact. I think we'll have a little fact. We can't get to the facts. So we'll just put the light bulb down. If you hadn't returned Edison's light bulb, we'd all be in the dark. Brilliant. Alright. So, he blocks up that door. There we go. If this glitches again, it's going off, I tell you. We'll do Mario's mission missing next, shall we? But I can play this. This is playable. I found an apple. I find Mario's Missing just totally unplayable. It's 1687. Who can tell me what happened in 1687 with an apple? Yeah. You are definitely learning. Okay, so let's hit this little thing here, and this will tell us, give us a little clue. There we go. Ah, Sir Isaac Newton. Before he was a sir, obviously. Newton's most famous law says that for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. That is correct. You should know this. Anyone listening to Ricky Gervais podcasts should know that anyway. Alright, why did I just do that? Let's bash that. What the fuck? Alright. There we go. By the way, you can't die on this game. See? There you go. There's the tree. Oh, didn't get on the tree. That's not good. Ah, oh, I don't want to. Yeah, gravity and blah, blah, blah. Right, on the tree. Put the apple on the tree. Thank you. Because you returned the apple, Newton will soon discover the principles of gravity when it falls to the ground. I'm sure they would have discovered gravity anyway. Right. Oh, you twat. Right, you have to watch out. If you go through the tunnels, it throws you back out. It gives me a chance to hit him, I suppose. And then hit him. And then hit. Oh, I missed him. Run over here in game. There he is. What's this? A sledgehammer. This is an interesting one. The sledgehammer is from 1989. The sledgehammer. 1989. You can tell me what is significant about a sledgehammer and 1989. Go. Sledgehammer. In 1989. Come on, what are they going to do with the sledgehammer in 1989? Who knows? Here we go. That's right. Another sledgehammer will come in handy. The Berlin Wall is about to collapse. Yeah, 1989. I remember that. I remember doing stuff in school about the Berlin Wall coming down. Right. Here we go. Okay. What have we got next? What is the next piece of the puzzle? Peter Gabriel probably would have been better. Sledgehammer. It's probably the 80s as well, isn't it? An egg. There you go. Come on, give me the fucking egg. The egg's easy. The egg is easy. Hope we're all ready for the egg. And it's 80 million BC. It was a good, yeah, it was a good video for the channel, wasn't it? Wow, look at the... Let's have a little thing. It says, over 450 million years ago, the sky was filled with pterodactyls whose wingspans ranged from 3 inches to 25 feet. I assume if we don't do this, then Yoshi would never be born. Because you returned the precious dinosaur egg, you have given new life to these magnificent creatures. All from one egg. Okay. Don't worry, in case you weren't worrying, don't worry, this doesn't go on forever. It gets better after you get all the things, it gets better and it gives you a quiz at the end. Right, a stovepipe hat. Which is 1862. I can see why this game never come out over here, and it's because 1862, a lot of it is American history, which we wouldn't really know anything about, would we? Being British or English, or whatever the fuck you want to call yourself. Go away. To the gate. Stovepipe hat. Thank you, Abe just hasn't been himself without his stovepipe hat. He even refused to sign the Gettysburg address without it. These Super Mario sprites. Do you think they actually look like Mario himself? He actually looks really good on a NES game with his sort of Mario World sprites. It's a shame they never made a game of it. Ooh. Well, you know, outside of this, but this isn't made by Nintendo, so. So can't believe you guessed the exact time. That's impressive. A steering wheel, and a steering wheel has got to go to 1520. Actually, I had to read that. Look, all right, 1520. This is right doing this, but the quiz at the end, I haven't got the answer to, so you probably see what a thick piece of shit I am at that point. Okay, we're on a ship. We can kill something here. Old school. There you go. This looks very much like one of Bowser's ships, doesn't it? Okay, because you have returned Magnilan's steering wheel, he can continue with his crew on this first voyage around the world. And the world wasn't flat. There you go. Sledgehammer. I'm going to spend my evening singing that now after I finish this. Oh, come on, you piece of shit. Pick it up. A flag. A flag. 1947. couldn't tell you what that one was for. I can't remember what the flag's for. It's a Zimbabwe flag or something, maybe. An African flag. Alright. Oh, it's here, isn't it? There you go. In front of the... return a new Indian flag. There you go. Marks the birth of a new nation, making Gandhi proud. Whenever you hear Gandhi, this is my curse. Whenever you hear Gandhi, I always think of the Buddha guy. I don't know why. In Ace Ventura 2. What's that? That is a. When you want to pick it up, a quill pen. A quill pen. 1602. Pretty easy this one. Shakespeare. 1602. I hope we've all learnt something tonight, by the way, from a bit of Mario is missing. Okay, let's find Shakespeare. Where is he? Oh, what's this? Ah, oh, Yoshi, Yoshi. Wherefore art thou, Yoshi? Who knows? Shakespeare. There he is. He's been chased off his stage. Here you go. Have your pen back. Now that you've returned his... quill pen, Shakespeare can continue to write his famous sonnets and plays. Yeah, cheers, Shakespeare. I enjoyed studying those for GCSEs. Alright, we're back in. We're back in the room. Look into the eyes, look into the eyes, look around the eyes, look directly into the eyes. An American flag. There we go. An American flag. Who can tell me the year? He's dead down a pit because we used the boost. Yeah. Oh. Poor Yoshi. 1969. Oh, this is an easy one, isn't it? 1969. We have an American flag. Who can tell me? 1969. With an American flag. You're under. Come on, where are we? We're on the fucking moon, aren't we? Look. Oh, look, the little Cooper Troopers wearing that. Is that Neil Armstrong? Thank you. Because you returned the flag, man's first land on the moon can be claimed by the United States. Well, I'm glad I managed to help you in the space race. Right. Maybe now we can end the Cold War. Okay. I helped the United States to take over the world. The loneliest man in the world. Yeah, it was all faked. Don't worry about it. A throne. 31 BC for the throne. I've got to take it to a pyramid, apparently. Alright. 31 BC. Oh, is that Cleopatra? Thank you. Oh, now that Cleopatra has her throne back, she can resume her reign as the Queen of Egypt. She. She did a better job than some of our fucking leaders in our country. A propeller. It's a fucking propeller. And we've got to go to 1903. Propeller's an easy one, isn't it? I love the music. Okay, there it is. There we go. Thank you. Now that you've returned the propeller, fasten your seatbelt and prepare for takeoff. Nothing about the Wright brothers. Yeah. Your spot on and give you a little like there if no one behind you. There you go. Okay. I love the fact you're watching this, Alistair, and guessing the answers. Right. I know what the next one is. I already know what the next one is, and there's nothing you can do about it. Alright, that is a sword. It's a big sword, I like that sword. Alright. Ryan's comment. Ryan Pascal, there you go, mate. I honestly think this could be one of the worst games I've ever seen. Well, you're probably right. He's pretty fucking terrible. I could show you some really awful NES games, really bad ones. Alright, so the red shrine. There's a green shrine, a yellow shrine, a green shrine. Oh, that must be the shrine. I must have to stand on the stage. Yeah. There we go. Thank you. What would a samurai be about his sword? Right, I'd like to just point out, what the fuck did we just learn from that? Yeah? Absolutely jack shit did we learn anything from that one. Okay. This is the last thing now before they give me a little quiz at the end, and you will see, honestly, my knowledge is awful. E equals MC squared. So we've got the physics equation, 1905. Yeah, you're probably right, this is actually better than Ren and Stimpy last night. At least this is a bit interesting. Samurais just need swords. There you go, it's got to be Einstein, hasn't it? Why are there Koopa Troopers in Einstein's lab? There he is. There you go, Einstein. There we go, thank you. Because you've returned the E equals MC squared formula of physics, students will have a reason to pull their hair out. Exactly. There we go, right, we've made it. We've made it to Bowser. All that remains now is to answer just a few questions before you can go on to rescue Yoshi from Bowser's evil clutches. Here we go. What form of mathematician did Newton invent? I have no idea. Someone would be there pulling their hair out now. But we'll say calculus. Hey, I can't remember if I got it right. How long did man's first flight last? 12 minutes. Ah. Oh. Damn, and it sends you, I've done this one earlier, it sends you out, it goes, go and find the answer to this. Don't bother finding the answer, don't bother, because you go and find the answer, as I found it earlier, let me do the test, it gives you different fucking questions. And it wasn't 12 minutes, it must have been 21 seconds. Right, yeah. The Japanese term is shogun, an abbreviation of, oh my god. God, a great barbarian general. anyone good at pop quizzes? Yeah, Mario's pretty proud of creating A bombs that will eventually be dropped on Japan and cause the death of millions of people. But it did stop the end of the war, so. Here we go, right. How long did the first flight? We're going to go 21 seconds. And that's not right, it's 12 seconds. You know the answers, Alistair, and we're 20 seconds apart from each other. This is ridiculous. Oh man, I wish you wouldn't just sit there though. Right, come on. Is it really 12 seconds? Really? Right, shh, there's a testing program. Ooh, so much. Alright. Oh, how long did the dinosaur survive on Earth? It's got to be 100,000 years, because the Earth. Is the Earth even a million years old? It's 3 million years old, isn't it, the Earth? Let's go for it. Oh, for fuck's sake. I'm going to start Googling these in a minute. You know what I mean? I'm going to hit the Google button. I think the next ones I get, I'm just fucking Googling it. We're going to start cheating. We're going to cheat at the test. We're going to cheat the test on Mario's time machine. First one again. Right. 12 minutes. 20. Was it 12 seconds? I've just pressed the wrong button! I can't even remember. Right, I'm gonna get the thing, I'm gonna get to the quiz, and I'm gonna stop. This is where I'm stopping right now, right? Well, I know this one, it was calculus, wasn't it? Yeah, okay. You're gonna help me with this next one, Alistair, if I need the help. Right. How many sonnets did Shakespeare write? I mean, who knows that? I mean, do you know the Shakespeare sonnets? 250, 37, 150. Come on. Come on, Alistair, you can help me with this. I'm going to sit here and wait for you. You seem to be a lot smarter than me. Come on, what is the sonnets? How many sonnets do you know? You've got 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Not a clue. Let's say over 150. Yes! Look at that. We need one more now, Alistair. One more. Are you still watching, Ryan? I hope you're watching, mate, because things are about to kick off. When was the Berlin Wall built? Alright, when was the Berlin Wall built? And we're definitely cheating. And we're going to put Berlin Wall into Google. And we're going to put it out. And it was built in 1961. There you go. We've cheated. Right, now it's time to find Yoshi and rescue him from Bowser. I knew when it came down. Here we go. Ryan, Alistair, you guys are with me. We're gonna take Bowser on. And it's the Bowser from Mario 3. Yes. This is actually turning into a bit of a game at this point. Look. Here we go. Come on. Oh, baby. So you knew the answer to that one. That, come on. Does he do anything? Does he breathe fire or anything? Or does he just... He literally... What have they done to Bowser? He's just walking back and forth. Look. What have they done to him? There you go. And a key. And there's Yoshi. And there we go. There we go. There we go. You win. That is a great... Look at Bowser crying. Look. And that's the end of the game. There you go. I'm definitely screenshotting that Bowser crying and using that at some point on the page. There he is again. Look. That is hilarious. Anyway, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the stream tonight. The Turtles game was a lot of fun. I'm gobsmacked to manage to do it. I'm even gobsmacked that Alistair managed to guess the exact time. And that's it, isn't it? Then there's Yoshi. He is awesome. Your time is gone, Ryan. I'm really sorry, mate. You should have accepted that badge. Then maybe I could have given the time back to you, but you've blown it now. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Tomorrow night, I'm not going to be on tomorrow night. I've got to decorate this room because it's my daughter's 5th birthday on Saturday, so we've got to put up banners and stuff. But I am going to upload Ninja Turtles, the first Ninja Turtles film. It's the video version as well, so it's carved shit. You will see it. If you're used to them, if you're used to like the Blu-ray version or the DVD version, you'll be surprised how much is missing from the old video version. But that, I'm going to have that running. And then Saturday, I think Alex is going on Saturday. He might be carrying on with his Mario, his Lost Levels, which is really cool. You should always watch him. And that is it. And I'll see you guys Sunday. So suggestions, because we're off the Turtles games till Thursday. Back to the Mega Drive, maybe. On maybe a SNES game. I don't know. Maybe a GameCube game. Who cares? and I'll see you guys. Thanks for watching, Alistair and Ryan. And I'll see you guys on Sunday night. Toodle pip, Longview01, signing out. My